Hi, good evening, everybody. Welcome to your Blessed Thankful Thursday Turning Point video, episode 426. Today we're going to be learning about drawing near, beginning with Exodus 33:14. We're going to be reading out of the Bible, James 4, verses 6 through 10. Our turning point is from Oliver Holden, and there is a footnote at the end of the middle paragraph. Right there where my finger is. And it's from something about A.W. Tozer. So, or it's something reported by A.W. Tozer. So, something he partnered with the person that's talking about in that paragraph and in a footnote comes from a book that he done along with that person. So, and your Bible reading is 1 Peter and 2 Peter. Just say it like that. So, because they've got it down 1 Peter chapter 1 through 2 Peter chapter 3. Which that means that's 1 Peter, 2 Peter. So, if you're excited about this, we'll smash the like button. Smashing the like button will help the video out in many different ways, including getting to other people. Excuse me. And, you know the drill on the Turning Point videos. How was your day today? How did your Thursday go? Are you inching closer getting ready for Christmas? And if you're in Florida, are you getting ready for your coldest Christmas in 30 years? The coldest Christmas season, coldest Christmas holiday in 30 years for Florida. Can you believe that? But, subscribe if you're new, turn on notifications, share the video and channel with your family and friends. Help me reach that 30 subscriber mark by January 1st, which is now 10 days away. And I would like to reach 100 subscribers for my birthday. I know that's a hefty number to try to reach, but if we can do it in other ways, we could do it. So, but I will appreciate it very much if you get me to 100 for my birthday. That's one birthday gift I want this coming birthday, is to be at 100 subscribers. So if you'll do that for me, I will thank you in advance. So, but drawing near, Exodus 33:14, my presence will go with you and I will give you rest. And that about the light goals, refer back to this morning's video for confirmation, for full details on what I was starting to do. So I just forgot to say that. So, back to it. The name Emmanuel means God with us. I wish they'd quit putting I in front of it. It's supposed to be E, not I. Because that's the way I've always learned it. It's the Emmanuel, not I-Manuel. It's not spelled I, it's spelled with an E. God with us, for Jesus came uniquely to show us how God would live among us. He came to show us how God lives, thinks, feels, decides, knows, and loves. When we see him, we see God. We also see the one who alone can bring us into God's presence. So James L. Snyder wrote, throughout the history of humanity, there have been great discoveries. I am not sure which one we could point to and say that is the greatest discovery in the world. But for the hungry heart, there is but one discovery that satisfies it, the discovery of the manifest conscious presence of God. And that comes from the book by A.W. Tozer, called Experiencing the Presence of God, along with James L. Snyder. Bloomington, Minnesota, Bethany House Publishers, 2014. So, that will be in the description box below. That footnote will be in the description box. So, you can look it up. So, that'll be there, and you can write it down and look it up. So, from the days of Adam... Wait a minute. Before we finish that last section, let's turn in our Bibles to James chapter 4, verses 6 through 10. I'm almost forgetting to do that one. James chapter 4, verses 6 through 10. But he gives me more grace, therefore he says, God resists the proud, but gives grace to the humble. Proverbs 3:34. Okay. 6 through 10. Therefore, submit to God, resist the devil, and he will flee from you. Draw near to God, and he will draw near to you. Cleanse your hands, you sinners, and purify your hearts, you double-minded. Lament and mourn and weep. Let your laughter be turned to mourning and your joy to gloom. Humble yourselves in the sight of the Lord, and he will lift you up. So from the days of Adam and Eve, God has longed to be with his people, and he wants to be with us forevermore. Whether he is here, where he is, there we will be forever. If only we thought about this more. The reality of God's manifest, conscious strengths, conscious presence strengthens us as we serve him each day. We can turn to him at any moment and speak to him. So this Christmas, enjoy the presence of God that Jesus came to provide. He will go with us and give us rest. Amen? So Oliver Holden says, if we live a life of prayer, God is presence everywhere. Short and sweet, but to the point. That's why they call it a turning point. It's the moral of the story. If we live a life of prayer, God is present everywhere. And it rhymes. Prayer everywhere. Kind of rhymes when you say it closely together. If with life of prayer, he is present everywhere. That's all I have for you today. Coming up tomorrow in your beautiful, fabulous Friday Turning Point, episode 4:27, we're going to be talking about Christmas joy on your Eve of Christmas Eve, Friday. Beginning with Luke 2:10-11, our recommended reading is Isaiah 9:6, the one where they said, he shall be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Prince of Peace, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. I probably said that verse right off the top of my head. And then Charles Spurgeon has the turning point, and they were reading 1 John, the book of 1 John. Might as well say. So, stay tuned to that. I'll get to that in just a few minutes, but you'll see that one tomorrow after 7. So, with that said, I love you. I appreciate you. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. Keep on keeping on and trusting God, and he'll keep you safe and all you say and do in 2022. So until tomorrow, peace out, everybody. So long, farewell. Come back tomorrow for another beautiful, fabulous Friday and the eve of Christmas Eve, 2022. Just 3 days left until Christmas, right now. And tomorrow will be two, and then, of course, you got Christmas Eve, and then you got Christmas on Sunday. So. But coming up tomorrow, after 7, part 1 of episode 939, we will be talking about We Can Know That We Know Him, from Henry M. Morse, beginning with 1 John 2, verse 3. Then part 2 after 1, hopefully after 1, we will be talking about part Granny Well from Kirsten Holmberg, derived from Psalm 71, 15 to 24. And in tomorrow's Turning Point at 7, we will be talking about Christmas Joy. Our beginning passage is Luke 2, 10 and 11. Isaiah 9:6 is our recommended verse, reading verse, and in our Turning Points from Charles Spurgeon, and in the Bible reading is 1 John. So, stay tuned for those. I'll get to those in a little, just a few minutes, but you'll see those tomorrow at 7, 1, hopefully after 1, and then 7 again, 7 p.m. So, with that said, God bless everyone, and I'll see you tomorrow. Have a great rest of your blessed, thankful Thursday evening, and come back tomorrow for a beautiful, fabulous Eve of Christmas Eve Friday. And I'll see y'all then. Goodbye.